And now to our team coverage on the cold weather. Winter certainly is making the most of its final days. You'll feel it as soon as you step out this morning. This means cold weather dangers, though, for those who have to spend extended periods of time outdoors, including those kids waiting at the bus stop.
Yeah, Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Carolina Cruz is live outside Connecticut Children's Medical Center this morning with advice from a doctor that will keep your child safe. Carolina.
Good morning. Make sure to get a good night's rest? What are you going to have for breakfast? These are questions that you should be asking your child before they head out the door. They're equally as important as what they wear to their bus stop. It's simply about being prepared, not only with your clothing, but also keeping in good health during these cold snaps. There's no hard rule on how long is too long for kids to be outside because a few variables factor in, and not so much dealing with clothing, instead with sleep, how much they had to eat, and overall health. But Dr. John Brancato does say the following is a major red flag.
It hurts. That's a simple rule of thumb. It's not very likely that kids will be at the bus stop likely long enough to develop a true hypothermia, but they certainly can have cold exposure in the ears. They lose a lot of heat from the tops of their heads.
Layers are key, and it doesn't have to be super thick layers. Wearing a fleece or a pullover that can be tucked away in a backpack at school makes it a full weather combo. Kids are notorious for not listening to their parents, so coming up in our next half hour, I'll tell you the one piece of advice they tend to listen to least. Reporting in Hartford, I'm Carolina Cruz, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
All right, Carolina, thank you.